Hi everybody, this is Ms. Meeker and I just want to show you what's inside of our packet and how I organized it this time. This is our second work packet. We've already did one before school. That's the one that was in the crochet bag. This one's going to come in a yellow folder. So the first thing you're going to do is open it up and you're going to see in between the pages is a Scholastic book order. And so I have the order form right here, but don't use that. What I need you to do is to, if you are interested, this is of course optional, go online to order your books. The ordering deadline will be September 17th, and then in about 2 weeks after that, hopefully we'll be back at school. I'm not 100% sure, as no one is. I can hand them out to you when we come back to school, or I can hand them out to you when we do one of our material distributions. And I'll have them here at school and I'll put them in bags for you. The nice thing about the Scholastic books is that they do tend to be a little bit cheaper online. They're 50 cents cheaper than they are in this flyer. And they are usually cheaper than you can get them at like Barnes & Noble or somewhere like that. Anyways, so when you open up your folder after you see that, you're going to see labels, week 1 and week 2. So you'll notice that I try to put everything you need in that weekly thing. And then if we're going to use them for both weeks, I will also put it in week 1. I'm just going to go through this super quick. This will be for a Humpty Dumpty tear art. This is a Humpty Dumpty. Obviously, we're doing Humpty Dumpty next week. Humpty Dumpty book for your child to read. We're going to be doing a pattern. You'll need both of these. And the sentence strip, oh, I'm going to put this down. You're going to get 1 Scholastic News or Let's Find Out magazine or My Big World about eggs. I didn't have enough of any one of them, so you have 1 of 2 different ones. There'll be a dot to dot. There'll be a sequencing. And I would recommend when we do the sequencing, you cut this out, just the outside dotted lines for your child, because they'll tend to want to cut this on top, some kids. So you cut that out. They can cut these straight lines here, and then we'll do that together. Do that when we do, we'll be doing our sequencing later next week, and do that right before we are in class and getting ready. Here's a poem of Humpty Dumpty to color in. And this, I think we're probably going to use next week, but I put it in the week 1 folder. It's another thing where you'll need to cut these out for your child. Your child will glue them in the right spot. We also have a new Benchmark workbook. And so put your child's name here. The pages are numbered, and I will tell you the numbers that you'll do for each night. There's not a ton of work to do in Benchmark workbooks yet, but when we do, I do assign them, I'll assign them by page number. In week 2, we're going to be using these cotton balls, so I put a little bag of cotton balls. We're going to be doing the poem Little Bo Peep, so there's a book. We will also be doing a pattern. So there'll be 3 different colors of sheep, plus a sentence strip to glue them on. And just like the week before, a lot of this stuff we kind of do with Beach. This is a poem for you to color. And these poems that have the 3-hole punch in them, I'd like for you to save in the memory book. We're going to keep those. And here's the sequence. And once again, if you can cut this out around for your child, and then they can cut in between each one and put it together when we do it as a class. And then finally, we have a little, just the fun activity. This is where we'll be gluing our cotton balls, whoops, right over here, and coloring in this paper. That's, in a nutshell, all the things we'll be doing. There will be a few more items from your first handout that we'll need to keep. There'll be some shapes that we'll be using. There'll be a cat worksheet that has pictures of cats on it that we'll be sorting. And there might be a few other things in there. Keep those. Don't throw those away. We'll be using those for math. So that's a rundown of what's in your folder. I hope you like how it's organized. If you have any questions, please call me or Well, don't call. I don't answer my phone at school, but you can email me and I'll get back to you. So thank you for listening and have a great weekend. Bye-bye.